dressed as Big Ben and his costume caught the top of the finish line arch.
Oh, not good. So the planning was good until that point. And how tired would you be at that stage of the marathon? That's what happens when you dress as a landmark.
Well, our producer, Leah LaRocque, they will really appreciate this because in running, like hundredths of a second makes a difference. He's trapped there for...
We should say that Leah is a very talented runner and she has run marathons. But she, as she just said, she's never done that. No.
First time for everything, Leah. Give it a try.
And speaking of Leah,
yeah,
she'll be in Quail. Because they're racing against time. They're building like a new berm.
Yep.
And so they're obviously just with some evacuation. So we're like, we're going to be tonight, Pembroke, Fort Collage, Cumberland, Clarence, Rockland. We got you covered. It's this story is just, it's kind of interesting to see that we have a crisis and then the rest of the city, you know, that's not written, but it's just a
directly
and everybody is
going along with their lives.
Yeah.
And you live by the water. It's a totally different situation.
I just cannot even fathom how tired people are at this stage.
You see it on
the exhaustion that you take. So support your neighbors if you can.
Yeah, and Joanne Schnur with that great story about the volunteers. That shows you Ottawa, right?
Sure does.
Yeah.
We will have full coverage at 5 and 6 o'clock tonight. Thanks for watching, everybody. Bye-bye.
Today on The So Show, are spoilers the real villains in the new Avengers movie? The harsh endgame one man faced when he revealed plot points outside a theater. Coloring outside the lines for a parenting contract. Why some moms and dads are signing baby nups to set the rules on domestic responsibilities. And are pictures of perfectly staged avocado toast on Instagram to fix? How influencers from the younger generation are smashing the social media standards. Then, must-have minimal waste beauty products that are making a difference and reducing our impact on the planet. Plus, the creator of the iconic Cappy comic, Cappy Guys White, is back with a new book about the highs and lows of raising her daughter while caring for her aging parents. It all starts now on The So Show.
Like, hey, this is what happens, okay? Because it's not cool. I just think that this is like so
much so that for the second time, the directors of the film, the Russo brothers, they actually tweeted out that they were asking straight up for people to not spoil it. They said, they issued a letter on Twitter, an open letter to their fans, and they said, because of so many of you that have invested your time, your hearts, and also your souls into these stories, we are once again asking for your help. When you see Endgame in the coming weeks, please don't spoil it for others. The same way you would have had it spoiled for you. And they ended with saying, remember, Thanos still demands your silence. Really funny about it. And I think that clearly they have money invested in it. They put in a lot of time. It's the 11th. So I get why. I'm just, again, more curious as to why you are the killjoy who would ever want to spill
it. I don't think you're going to be able to ever unpack that. That is some kind of bizarreness. But I think it gets harder and harder. The more we are into social media and people are checking it, it is hard to avoid spoilers. It used to be back in the day, you know, if you didn't watch a really important show, you didn't watch it, you might be able to get away for a significant amount of time not hearing the end of that, you know, that series. But nowadays, you have to actively avoid. And I do think some of the onus is on you. If you, like, let's say Game of Thrones was on last night. Yeah, for those of us who are, like, diehards for that show, like, there were some really intense plot points that happened last night. And my first urge, though, this morning was to go, and, like, my boss is a huge fan as well. And we went into the makeup room, and you just, part of the pleasure is you want to talk about it, you want to unpack it, you're just so excited. But our makeup artist, one of them, she's also a fan, she didn't see it last night. So we had to be like, oh, hey, we're going to kind of talk in code, but not really talk at all. And we're going to sort of talk around it, because that's kind of etiquette. But if it had been like a week from now, I'm not sure how respectful I would. You got a week. You got a week grace period.
Zachary has some thoughts.
Okay.
So Zachary wrote some thoughts on Facebook, and Zachary says, my biggest pet peeve is people on social media that get upset over communal live event spoilers. If you cared enough about the event, then you would A, watch it live like a real fan, or B, avoid social media.
Seen